Hi everyone, and welcome to today's video, which we are going to look at some advanced data types used in Siemens PLC programming. In this video, we will learn together how to create and use an array, structure, and user-defined data type in Siemens TIA portal to make our program more readable and simpler. To follow along with this tutorial, you will need a basic understanding of basic data types. You can find some information about data types in video number 15 of TIA portal tutorial. The first data type that I want to talk about is arrays. Consider a situation where we need to store 5 integer numbers. If we use programming, simple variables, and data type concepts, then we need 5 variables of integer data type, and the program will be as follows. It was simple because we had to store just 5 integer numbers. Now let's assume we have to store 100 integer numbers. Are we going to use 100 variables? To handle such situations, most all programming languages provide a concept called an array. An array is a collection of items of the same data type stored at a memory location. This grouping of data of the same type makes it easy to manage, access, and modify it. In our example, instead of declaring individual variables, we just declare one array variable of integer type, consisting of 5 elements. Here 1 to 5 are indexes associated with our variables, and they are being used to represent individual components available in the array. The index limitations are defined in square brackets, and the data type is defined after the keyword of when creating an array tag. Let's declare an array in TIA portal. Open TIA portal and using add new block inside the folder program blocks, create a new data block. Write a name for your array. Then write under the data type array. Select array data type. Now TIA wants you to determine the data type used for the array. Array of Boolean, array of integers, and so on. In our example, it's integer. For array element count, let's set it 0 to 4 or 1 to 5. You can use the pop-up windows here or write directly in this box. An array in TIA portal does not necessarily need to start with element 0. Unlike other platforms where an array can only start with element 0, TIA portal gives you more control by letting you choose your starting element. Now we have defined an array with 5 elements. If you click on here, you can see them. Element number 1 of type integer, and here the start value. Now we have defined our array and we want to assign a value to these elements inside the program. Let's see how we can access the array elements in our program. Open main OP, insert the move instruction, I'm going to assign 10 to the number 1. So in input will be 10 and out 1 will be our array element. Click on here and select an element. Let's use a contact to activate this move. And with another move, 20 to the third array element. We can also drag and drop the array tag. I'm going to add a function to show you how to access array elements with SCL programming language. Select SCL as the programming language. Now we need first to write the data block name. If you write some word, Tia will suggest you the data block. With a point, again, Tia portal will show you the defined data types inside this data block. If you select the first one, all the elements will be selected. If you need to assign a value to a specific array element, select the second one and write the index inside the brackets. Now with the assignment, you can have access to an array and change the value using SCL. Like ladder, we can use drag and drop to insert an element into our program. Call the FC inside the main OB. Let's simulate the program. I'm going to activate the monitoring of the data block. Our numbers are still 0 because M0.0 has a false value and move block and also FC is not active yet. Modify it to 1. Now the move instructions and FC are active and we have changed the values of the element as we have defined in our program. The next point about arrays is that we can also create an array using constants for the lower and upper limits. I'm going to create 2 user constants, open PLC tags. Let's name the constants M and N. Use them as upper and lower bounds of our array. Be careful, our variables are global, so we need to use quotation marks. Download the changes. As you see, the upper and lower bounds of the array are set now with our constants. The next data type is structure. With arrays, we have a collection of same data types. In our example, all the components were integer. But when we need to collect different kinds of data types, how we can do that? Suppose in a production line, we want to monitor and control the data of a motor and a tank. Name, a contact to start and stop the motor, time of being on and off, current speed, and ambient temperature. For the tank, again, all this data plus pressure. So we need to declare different kinds of variables to store the data. The name is string. We need Boolean variables to start and stop the motor, a variable of data type time, and integer. So this is how I have stored the data using some variables. If we had another device that we needed to store its data, then we would have lots of variables and not be easy to identify which variable belongs to which device. In this case, we can use structure to categorize our variables and make our code easier and more readable. The struct data type represents a data structure that can be used to group elements of different types into a single type. So we can define a structure, and inside the structure, we will have these different data types. Let's create a structure in TIA portal. Creating a structure is like arrays. Write a name and select struct as the data type. You see, a row will be created automatically for our variables. We have a name, it's a string. A Boolean to start and stop. time, speed, and temperature. Let me define it with a real data type. Create another struct for the tank. You can copy and paste these variables. And pressure. As we can see, different data types are contained in the struct data type, each one under a specific category. Access to a structure is like how we used arrays. Create another move instruction. Drag and drop the tag here. With FC, write the data block name plus point. Then select motor or tank. Again, a point and select the variable. With an assignment, we can define a name for our tank. And define the temperature. Start simulation. As you see, we could classify our variables under motor and tank using struct data type and change their values in our program. The last one is the UDT user defined type. Suppose in our example, we have 10 motors and we are using structure. We need to copy and paste the structure for each motor. Alternative to this, we can use UDT and define only one tag for each motor. So we can create our own data type motor, including different data types. When generating data blocks, you can designate PLC data types as a type. You can create several data blocks based on this type, all of which have the same data structure. These data blocks can be customized by changing the actual values for the appropriate task. Let us now continue by creating a new PLC data type in TIA Portal. Under the project tree, navigate to the PLC data type and create a new one. A default name is assigned for the newly created PLC data type. I'm going to change it to motor. Copy all the tags for the motor. Now, like a struct, we have defined a data type that consists of different data types. If we go to the data block, we can define tags for different motors using our UDT. But before that, click on PLC and compile the program. If you don't do that, PLC will not have access to the UDT. Motor 1 and expand this menu to choose data type and scroll down to the bottom. We should see the UDT that we have just created before. Create another tag, motor 2 and 3 and so on. If you expand each motor, you will see the same data type that we have defined inside the UDT. We can easily use our tag just like structures. Open main OB, create a new move block, Again, with drag and drop or selecting from this box, you can have access to your data type. And let me change an element inside FC. Download the chains. Click on glass to monitor the values. As you see, we have changed these values of the motors. An important point about UDT is that imagine after you're done with your programming, you need to store another value of the motor. Then you need to add another variable to the UDT. For example, let's store motor direction during the runtime. As you see, the data type is red now because Tia detected a new variable inside the UDT. In this case, you don't need to delete anything and create a new UDT. Just click on PLC and compile the program, software, and rebuild all the blocks. If you go to the data block, you see the new type is added. That's it. We could create our own data type and have access to the values. At face value, a struct and a UDT have many similarities, but there are some differences between them. UDT and struct perform the same fundamental function, but a UDT is much more powerful than a struct. This is because a struct is a singular instance of a group of variables and a UDT is an actual data type. UDT helps make the project lifecycle more efficient. Once a UDT has been created, it can be multiplied in the program and transferred as a library to another project. Alright, our today's video about advanced data types in Tia Portal is finished. Hope this video was helpful for you. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to write it in comments. Bye!